Hello, my draconic scholar. Today, I'll be showing you how to download and install all the mod 6 using curse. I will leave all the information and timestamp in the description down below, so make sure to click on that. Head on over to curseforge.com. There, you'll be able to find the download link right here. Download curseforge app. Make sure to install Overwolf, or if you don't like Overwolf, don't install it. After you're done downloading curseforge, you're going to see this icon and Overwolf. So those are the two. We aren't going to show off Overwolf. That is a overlay application. We're not gonna need that. We're only gonna be focusing on curseforge. That's what you need in order to play Minecraft or any modded game such as Darkest Dungeon. So open it. First, what you want to do is log into Twitch. This little door icon right here called login. Login, connect with Twitch. This is going to ask for your username and password. I'm gonna quickly log in. Should be login. There we go. Perfect. Now that you are logged into Curse, you can click on to Home and select Minecraft. If you have Minecraft installed, it will automatically show up here. Choose Minecraft and it will pop up a new window saying Minecraft right here. In order to install all the mod 6, you just need to go to Browse ModPack. And the category, or you can just type in the search bar right here, are the mod 6. After you do that, press enter and it will load up all the mod 6. Make sure it is version 1.16.4, the newest update. Updated 6 days ago. The creator is ATM Team. Very lovely. Click play and it will start installing. Since I already installed, it is not going to install a new one. It is just going to check for update for the current one and launch the Minecraft. But we're not going to worry about that right now. I'm going to close it for now. I'll show that later. Okay. If you run into any trouble so far, I will leave common solution. I will leave common error and common solution in the description down below. And if you have any problem, just ask me in the comment section or contact me via Discord. Okay, once you're done downloading it, it usually takes about 30 minutes to 1 hour. For me, it took 1 hour. My internet is really bad. So it took me 1 hour to download 200 mods from all the mod 6. After you got it downloaded, I recommend right clicking it and clicking open folder. Usually all the mod 6 does not have Optifine, and I highly recommend you go with downloading Optifine. Yeah, all the mod 6 does not have Optifine. I will leave Optifine in the description down below. So make sure to go download Optifine version 1.16.4, the newest one. Download HDUG5. Oh, ad blocker. Really? Let me quickly get Optifine 1.16.4 downloaded first before doing anything. I'm gonna click on the mirrored download. Hopefully this one is gonna allow me to download. If the first link doesn't work, use the mirrored download. There we go, lovely stuff. Click OK, save it. Once it is done downloading, show in folder. And there is my lovely Optifine. I won't be using a patcher or any animation, any other mod. I will only be doing Optifine into the mod pack. This is gonna allow you to have more FPS and allows you to use shaders. I will be using shaders for other YouTube video, but for this for future video, I will be using shaders. So look forward to that. Optifine, let's drag and drop it in. 1.16.4. Make sure it is in the correct folder, the mods folder. Okay, close out of there. Go back into your curseforge. Click play. This should open up the Minecraft vanilla launcher, but loaded with all the mod 6 profile. Yeah, loaded with all the mod 6. Okay, as you can see, it says all the mod 6 profile right there, Forge 35.1.4. So go over to installation before you start. Don't start yet because you might not have enough RAM to run this. I recommend 4 to 8 GB of RAM. Any more is going to be overkill, and any less you're going to crash when you play the game. So 6 is a good amount of RAM to have. 6 GB of RAM is a good amount to have. For me, I'm going to have 8. So in order to see how much RAM you got, go into your search. If you're on Windows 10, on Mac, I don't know, but on Windows, you go to search and type system information. You want to be looking for your physical memory, RAM, right here. Physical memory, right here. 16 GB. Don't look at anything else, just this one. And if you haven't installed Java, you make sure to go install the newest version of Java. You can figure out what system type you are, 64 or 32-bit. My system is 64-bit, so I need to download Java 64. If your window is running on 32-bit, I will leave the download link for that in the description down below as well. You do need the newest version of Java to run Minecraft smoothly. Okay. I will be showing you the download link as well. So java.com, there we go. I will also leave, I'll leave the Java download link in the description. Just accept all the cookies. I usually don't like accepting the cookies, but in this situation, I have no choice. So agree and download. You also could go to the Oracle Java SE. This version automatically detects that I am running on Windows 64. So I save and install, but I already installed, so I don't need to. Okay, so we're gonna close out of Java and we're gonna go back into Minecraft. This is important. This is really important. You go into installation. First you add play. Go into installation right here. Click on the little 3 dot, click edit. Once you're in here, click on more option. In the more option panel, you can see that this is your JVM argument. Click reset. By default, it should look different from mine. So you need to click reset to reset it back to the vanilla default one right here. This is the string of code. You don't need to edit any of it. You just need to change the 2 GB right here to the desired amount. For me, I do not want 2 GB of RAM. That is going to crash constantly. We are going to put in 8 GB of RAM, and that will automatically update the rest of the code later on. So click save, and now you're ready to play. Make sure to log into your Minecraft account. For the current season of Trasmensis, I am running all the mod 6 on the server. So if you want to play with me or play online, make sure to download all the mod 6 before joining in to Trasmensis. I'll be streaming Trasmensis every other day on Twitch TV, Aiko to Draco. Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday at 7 a.m. EST. I'll be streaming Trasmensis on Twitch TV, Aiko to Draco. Now you just have to wait until Minecraft loads in completely. So I'm going to jump cut when Minecraft has done loading 200 mod. This takes about 10 minutes for my PC. So I'll see you soon. Okay, after 30 minutes, this is what you are going to see. You can go to single player and create a new world, but for me, I'm not going to play single player. I am going to play multiplayer. So we're gonna exit out of here. This is the all the mod 6 loading screen. I have successfully loaded everything. Let's go to multiplayer and add a server. I'm going to be adding my Minecraft server, Trasmensis apex.co. So let's add that. Here we go, Aiko's server. Actually, I'm gonna name it all the mod 6. There we go. So click done, and it should show you the server. Wait for it to ping. Type your in-game name in the comment section down below. I will pick a random winner to be whitelisted onto my server 48 hours from this video going live. we get to play on the Mod 6. I will be making a lot of YouTube video on Sky Factory 4 and on the Mod 6, so look forward to that. The same process for Sky Factory 4 as well. The same process to install Sky Factory 4. If you want to know how to install Sky Factory 4, just do the same thing as AutoMod 6, but instead of searching for AutoMod 6, you search for Sky Factory 4. And that is it. It does take a little bit of time to get into the server. By the way, the launch time took me over 30 minutes. So if your game takes a long time to launch, that's just because of your Java version or your PC. For me, it is my PC. 30 minutes just to get in. It's a long time, but it's worth it for all the Mod 6. There's tons of content that I enjoy playing. You guys can click here for the recommended YouTube video, or you can click over here for my Minecraft how-to playlist. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you all in the next one. Bye!